Hi, my name is Chris and this is Battle Nonsense. Today I want to talk about some of those tips and tricks that you can find on the internet which allegedly fix netcode issues in some games, lower your ping and improve your online experience. One trick that you will come across is changing the MTU setting on your router or inside the properties of your network adapter. But what is that MTU? MTU stands for Maximum Transmission Unit and defines how much data you can put into a single data packet. You can think of it like a weight limit on a road or a highway. When there is a weight limit, then a truck must stay below that limit. So when you want to transport more than you are allowed to put on a single truck, then you have to split the load and use more than one truck. The exact same thing happens when an application wants to send a data packet which has 1500 bytes, but the router has an MTU of 1400 bytes. In this case, the router must split that packet. It then sends one with 1400 bytes and a second one which contains the remaining 100 bytes. The receiving host will then reassemble those fragments so that the application or service on the other end can read that data. So the MTU is like that weight limit on a highway. As long as the packets stay below that limit, they can just pass right through the router. When one is larger than the MTU, then it will get fragmented by the router. This is of course an extremely simplified explanation, as I am just using the size of the payload here and I am not going to dive into details like the path MTU discovery. What I want to achieve here is help you to understand what the MTU is and what it does. Now, how do you know which MTU value is the right one for your internet connection? Many routers have an auto setting for the MTU, others, like the edge routers, require that you enter a value. Now, there are guides on the internet which tell you how you can use the ping command and its do not fragment flag to figure it out on your own. But the easiest solution is to simply call your internet service provider and ask them which MTU you must set on your router. There is really no point in figuring this out manually, as using the wrong value can lead to serious connectivity issues. So just ask your internet service provider and enter that value in the configuration of your router, and only on your router. Leave the properties of your network adapter alone. But why do some people think that a lower MTU value would reduce their lag? The only explanation that I have is that those who believe that think that the MTU is a buffer on the router which first must be filled before one packet of the size of the MTU then gets sent. But this is not what the MTU is used for. Packets that are smaller than the MTU will just pass right through the router, and packets that are larger will get fragmented. So lowering the MTU on your router or network adapter will not reduce your lag. It will only cause more packets to get fragmented, which can increase the delay, especially when you suffer from packet loss. It will increase the CPU load on your router as well as at the receiving host, and it might even result in major connectivity issues, especially when an application uses the do not fragment flag for its data packets. The MTU value that you get from your ISP will also hardly cause that data packets from online games get fragmented, simply because the data packets that games send and receive are much smaller than your MTU, as you can see here in this network capture from Fortnite. So in short, the MTU trick, which tells you to enter a value that is lower or higher than the one that you are told by your internet service provider, is utter nonsense. It does not reduce the network delay in online multiplayer games. Now, since the MTU trick is just snake oil, how about the Leatrix latency fix, the TCP optimizer and similar tools? In the past I've tried many different tools, scripts and tricks which all claimed to either reduce lag, latency variation, packet loss or improve the hit registration. Long story short, none of them ever had a measurable impact on the network delay in my tests. If you want to know more about how I do my network delay tests for online multiplayer games, then you should check out my Netcode 101 video and my netcode analysis videos that you can find on my channel. In that Netcode 101 video, I also show you how you can troubleshoot your connection to the server and gather data which can help the support of your internet service provider to track down the issue. Now, every game uses TCP connections to, in example, communicate with the backend, like the login and statistics servers. But the reason why none of these TCP optimizers have an impact on the network delay of the vast majority of online multiplayer games is that Battlefield, Call of Duty, Doom, Quake, PUBG, Fortnite, Rainbow Six Siege, Overwatch, Lawbreakers, Destiny, Rocket League, Star Citizen, literally every online multiplayer game uses the UDP protocol for the time-sensitive game data, not the TCP protocol. So these tools and scripts tweak a protocol that is not even used for the data which is related to the lag you experience. Sure, there are some older games, primarily MMOs like World of Warcraft, which use the TCP protocol for the time-sensitive game data. but with the exception of Ironside, I have not seen any other game developer make the major mistake of using TCP instead of UDP for game data in recent years. I also talked about this in my netcode analysis for Ironside. The problem with TCP is that it was designed to ensure that data always arrives at its target location, even if that means that you must resend the same data again and again, which increases the delay. It is also meant to provide efficient data transfer, which is why per default data gets buffered first and will only be sent once that buffer is full, which increases the delay even more. So, for the handful of games which use TCP for game data, these scripts and tools can help to reduce the network delay slightly. However, I tried all of them with Ironside, one of the few games that uses TCP for game data, and these had no impact whatsoever on the network delay that the player is affected by. But that wasn't a surprise really, as the Ironside developers at least set TCP no delay, which can be seen by the TCP push flag in Bioshock. This means that data will not only be sent immediately instead of getting buffered first, the receiving server is also informed that this data must get pushed up to the receiving application immediately, in this case the instance of the game server. So, any tool or script which disables the Nagle's algorithm on my PC does not affect the network delay in Ironside, as the game already takes care of that. So basically, these scripts and tools do not decrease lag, they do not eliminate packet loss, and they do not improve the hit registration for the vast majority of online games, while they can potentially cause serious connectivity issues if you tweak the wrong values. This is why you should simply stay away from them, as you just can't optimize the Windows network settings so much that these changes would have a noticeable impact on the delay of today's online multiplayer games, at least if these were coded by people who know what they are doing, which means that they use the UDP protocol for game data, which was designed for real-time applications such as online games. If you want to know more about TCP versus UDP for game data, then you should read the excellent article that I have linked to in the description down below. So since none of these tricks or tools work, what can you do to improve your connection in online multiplayer games? Just like I explained in my last video about WT Fast, Haste and Outfox, you should stay away from Wi-Fi as much as possible, as that is prone to interference and congestion, which results in ping spikes and packet loss. Use a wired connection and make sure that your router does not suffer from buffer bloat, as that can cause ping spikes of several hundred milliseconds, as well as packet loss. If you want to know more about that, then you should check out the video that I've linked to in the description down below. And that's all for today. If you enjoyed this video about these pro tips and optimization tools that you can find on the internet, then it would be great if you could support me on Patreon, as YouTube's ad revenue is sadly not enough anymore to run a niche channel like mine. Without the awesome support that I get from my patrons, Battle Nonsense would not exist anymore. You can find a link to my Patreon in the description down below, where you will also find links to my social accounts in case that you want to stay up to date on the videos that I'm working on. So if you enjoyed this video, then please give it a like, subscribe for more, and I hope to see you next time. Until then, have a nice day and take care. My name is Chris, and this was Battle Nonsense.